What's going on, guys? So today I bring you another review of a blank pistol. I was going through my video manager the other day and it seemed that my previous blank gun videos were pretty popular. So I recently bought another one and I'm going to review it. So as you can tell by the case, this is the Ekol Special 99 Revision 2. So the Revision 2 is basically got a double stacked magazine and I think that's pretty much it. As you can see, got a cover here for the box. Has some advertising for the other colors that the gun comes in the back. Take it out of this little case here for the cover. And you got a plastic hard shell case with your gun and a manual and a brochure. So, go ahead and take it out of the box. I can show you what it comes with here. You have your instruction manual, which is pretty vague. It tells you some specifications, how to load it, and to field strip it. It does not show any pictures, so field stripping can be a little tricky if you've never done so on, you know, an M8, M9 format. And a little brochure that gives you Ekol's lineup of blank pistols. I guess they do make a lot of stuff because this is a pretty big list of guns. I won't show you all of it, but it's there. Now to the gun itself. Now, this is one of your cheaper blank gun pistols. This one is front firing. Not sure if I mentioned that before, but it is a front firing model. So it does not come out the top. It comes out the front like a real gun would. So this was about 80 bucks on Max Armory. Even though it says it's a flare model, the end of the barrel is threaded, but it did not come with a flare adapter for some reason. So, oh well, let's put all this aside because it's going to blow away because we got a friggin' dust bowl going on out here. Anyway, so yeah, we have full metal construction. It's the gloss black finish, double stacked magazine, as you can see, 14 or 15 round capacity, 9mm pack ammunition. So yes, it is a full metal construction. The grips are plastic. Make sure it's clear. It is double and single action. The first thing I noticed when I went to fire this is the slide is actually very stiff. It's even stiffer than some handguns I've fired in my time. So it actually is very stiff. You really got to kind of grip on it. There's a very small area here on the slide where you have a rough surface for your fingers to catch. So it can be kind of tricky sometimes, especially if you have bigger fingers like me. When I first got this gun, I was surprised because it looked a lot smaller than I thought it would be. So as you can see, it just almost fits completely in the palm of my hand. Especially the slide. The slide is very low profile. So it has your typical functions of a handgun. So you got your safety, mag release here, force your trigger, field strip, levers. I won't demonstrate it now because I've only done it once before and I don't want to look like a fool if I mess up. You have your logos here, tells you the caliber, the brand, you know, so on and so forth. You even have a serial number here at the bottom. I'm not sure if the camera will pick that up. You can kind of see it. Yeah, there's a little serial number which I'm guessing is unique to each one. So, like I mentioned, this is one of the cheaper models. One flaw I started to notice immediately was how easily the finish wore off on the slide, body, and other parts of the gun just from normal use. You can see around the barrel, paint's kind of chipping away. Aside from the aesthetics though, the sturdiness of the gun, it does feel really solid. The hammer feels really good. There's not a lot of play at all in the moving parts. Everything is, it's everything feels very tight and very durable as far as the, mechanical wise. So that's good. I have put about 100 rounds through it so far and I actually did not experience any jams whatsoever. However, one thing I forgot to do was when I started firing this, I forgot to oil the gun, so what happened is after the last round, the slide catch wouldn't function, so it would not lock back. Kind of worried me at first. I thought maybe there was something wrong, and then I kind of thought about it. I'm like, oh wait, I didn't oil the gun. So I field stripped it, oiled everything, and now the slide catch works perfectly. So yeah, that's what I would recommend you do before you start firing this, is to lubricate it fully. So the magazine, like I said, it's a double stacked, I believe 14 to 15 round capacity. It does feel kind of flimsy though. It's got a plastic, I'm gonna call it a butt plate, I guess. I forget what these are called technically, whatever. It is plastic on the bottom here. It does not feel like that strong of plastic too. I can easily kind of bend it, and yeah, it just doesn't feel too sturdy, so I wouldn't be slamming mags too hard or, you know, just ejecting them whenever. Metal is quite thin. However, despite it being thin, it doesn't bend easily, so it's probably made out of a more durable steel. The spring in the magazine is pretty stiff. However, all the rounds stack up perfectly in the magazine, and like I said, I have not experienced any jams so far. You know, you got your safety. Sights are very low profile because this is designed to be a compact gun. So, I mean, not that it really matters because you're not shooting any projectiles, but it's just something to note. And I think I've just about covered everything on this pistol. So, what we're going to do is we're going to wait for it to get a little darker out. We're going to put some rounds in it. We're going to fire it, and I'll show you the cool muzzle flash it has. Alright, let's take a few shots. Guess we're empty. Slide didn't lock back that time, but maybe just gotta oil it a little more. Alright, so before we end off this video, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this front firing blank pistol, put it up to this apple, and see if there's enough charge to come out of the barrel to disintegrate the apple. There's been a lot of talk going around that the percussion from the charge, if you put it to your head, basically it can kill you because the percussion is so strong. So what I'm going to test is just to see how powerful the charge actually is. It might vary per caliber and size of the round, I guess. So it's a 9mm pack, and we're going to see what it does to this apple, see if there's anything significant. Right up to it. Holy shit. Okay. Jesus. Okay. Yeah, we got pieces all over the place. Big chunk of it over there. Some more chunks. I am completely sprayed with bits of apple. Got apple juice everywhere. So yeah, I think that definitely proves that a charge from a blank pistol can be very deadly. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little review and shooting test of the Ekol Special 99. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.